Good morning students, welcome to the class, and this video is for the basic concept of chemistry, and today we discuss about mole concept. So first of all, what is mole? Then you can consider mole as a unit. And value of mole is equals to Avogadro's number. That is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Okay, 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Now, we can write that 1 mole is equals to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Okay, this is the value of 1 mole, and this is equals to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms. 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 molecules. 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 gram atoms. And 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 gram molecules. Now, all these things, atoms, molecules, gram atoms, gram molecule, have same value, that is equals to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23, and that is what? That is Avogadro number, and 1 mole is equals to this. So it is clear now, 1 mole is equals to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23, which is similar to 1 mole atom, 1 mole molecule, 1 mole gram atom, 1 mole gram molecule. Okay. Now, next thing is, this is very important. Mole is given weight divided molecular weight. Given weight upon molecular weight. You can write given weight as W and molecular weight as capital M. So, what is this W and this capital M? If we consider glucose, formula is C6H12O6. If we consider sugar, the formula is C12H22O11. Then this glucose and sugar have a molecular formula, have a chemical formula. This is C6H12O6 and C12H22O11. This is fixed. This formula is always fixed, like H2O for water, CO2 for carbon dioxide, NH3 for ammonia gas, SO2 for sulfur dioxide. All these are always fixed. So the mass obtained from this chemical formula is known as molecular mass. Like for C, that is 12, for H, that is 1, for O, that is 16. Now, for glucose, it is, for glucose only, the molecular mass will be 12 into 6 plus 1 into 12 plus 16 into 6. Now, this 12 into 6 implies for carbon, this 1 into 12 implies for hydrogen, and this 16 into 6 implies for oxygen. Now, the total value will be 180. This is what? This is gram. Okay. Now, in the same way, the molecular weight of sugar will be the molecular weight of sugar will be C12H22O11, that is 12 into 12 plus 1 into 22 plus 16 into 11. Now this becomes 144, this becomes 22, and this becomes 176. The total value becomes 342. This is what? This is gram. And 342 is what? This is molecular mass. Molecular mass of what? Of sugar. This is molecular mass of sugar. So molecular mass is always fixed. Either we have one molecule of sugar or 1 kg sugar, the molecular mass is always fixed. The molecular mass is always fixed either we have any quantity of sugar. But what is the given mass? What is the given weight? This is a variable weight. This is what? This is variable weight. Like 100 gram, 250 gram, 500 gram, 1000 gram. Okay, all these values can be possible for a shopkeeper, for us. Why? Because these values are variable values. So we can demand for 100 gram sugar, 250 gram sugar, 500 gram sugar, 1000 gram sugar. Okay, so these are the values which can be different. So now mole is W upon M. So if there is a question, calculate the number of mole of CO2 present in 100 gram of its sample. ठीक है, ओके. नाउ दिस इज द क्वेश्चन, कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ मोल ऑफ सीओ टू प्रेजेंट इन 100 ग्राम ऑफ इट्स सैंपल. देन गिवन वेट इज इक्वल्स टू व्हाट? दिस इज 100 फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन. मॉलिक्यूलर वेट फॉर सीओ टू दैट इज 12 प्लस 16 प्लस 16 इक्वल्स टू व्हाट? इक्वल्स टू 44. नाउ from this formula, given weight upon molecular weight, the number of mole will be 100 upon 44. 100 upon 44. So this will become 25 upon 11, and finally 2.2 mole. Then this is the number of mole of CO2 present in 100 gram sample of CO2. Now next thing is, how many carbon atoms present in 2.2 moles? How many carbon atoms present in 2.2 mole? Since 1 mole CO2 contain, okay, now one molecule of CO2 contains one atom carbon. Okay, one molecule of CO2 contain one atom of carbon. Then one mole will contain 1 into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of carbon, because 1 mole have molecules 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Now next is, so 2.2 mole will contain 1 into 2.2 into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. This is the value of number of carbon atoms present in 2.2 mole of CO2. If we want to calculate number of oxygen atom present, then number of oxygen atom, then we should multiply with 2 into 2.2 into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 oxygen atoms. Why? Because one molecule of CO2 contain two atoms of oxygen, then the number of oxygen atom, the total number of oxygen atom present in 2.2 mole will be equals to 2 into 2.2 into Avogadro's number, because this is the value of oxygen atom present in one molecule, this is the total number of mole and this is the Avogadro's number. Okay, I hope it is clear. Then the next topic. How many ions will produce when 1000 gram CaSO4 will dissociate? Okay, this is the question. How many ions will produce when 1000 gram CaSO4 will dissociate? Then first of all, we have to write the dissociation equation for CaSO4. That is what CaSO4 goes to give Ca2 positive plus SO4 2 negative. Ca2 positive plus SO4 2 negative, because calcium is a divalent cation and sulfate is a divalent anion. Then from this equation, the total number of ions is 2, one for calcium 2 positive and one for SO4 2 negative. Then one molecule gives 2 ion, then we have to calculate number of mole first. Number of mole is equals to W upon M. Then W is equals to what? W is equals to 1000 and M is equals to what? For CaSO4, the M is 40 for Cm, 32 for sulfur and 16 into 4 for oxygen. Then this will become 40 plus 32 plus 64. Okay, then it is what? 136. Then the value of M is 136. Now 1000 upon 136, this is what? This is number of mole. So total ions in 1000 gram will be equals to 1000 upon 136 into Avogadro's number 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 into 2. Now this is the answer. This is the mole value, this is Avogadro's number, and this is the number of ion present in one molecule. Okay, next reaction, calculate number of ions in 50 gram AlCl3. AlCl3 gives Al3 positive plus 3Cl negative. So total number of ion is, total ion is equals to what? One for Al3 positive and 3 for Cl negative. Then 1 plus 3 is equals to what? 4. Total number of ions is equals to 4. Then W is equals to 50 and M is equals to what? AlCl3. For Al, this is 27. For Cl, that is 35.5 into 3. Then we have to calculate this molecular mass first. Then this is the given mass. Then the final answer will be 50 upon molecular mass into Avogadro's number into 4. This is the final answer for this type of question. Okay, now so this is clear that mole is a unit. Okay, now there is one more thing, that is concentration. Concentration. Then question is that what is concentration? This is basically the amount of solute present in solution. Okay, the amount of solute present in solution. This is what? This is concentration. And for the basic of mole concept, there is some types of solution like molarity, molality, normality, and mole fraction. Molarity, molality, normality, and mole fraction. Now, first, molarity. Molarity. This is a concentration term defined as the number of mole of solute present in per liter of solution. Number of mole of solute present in per liter of solution. Okay. So we can write that molarity is equals to WB upon MB into volume and into 1000. If this volume is in ml, then this B stands for solute. And if this is WA, then this A stands for solvent. And W stands for given weight. And B is solute and A is solvent. Then MB is molecular weight of solute. This V is what? V is volume of solution. V is volume of solution. Then the unit for this molarity term like molarity will be equals to WB upon MB into volume into 1000. Then its unit is mole per liter. The next one is molality. Then this molality is number of mole of solute present in पर केजी ऑफ सॉल्वेंट, पर किलोग्राम ऑफ सॉल्वेंट. देन वी कैन राइट स्मॉल m इज इक्वल्स टू डब्ल्यू बी अपॉन एम बी इंटू डब्ल्यू ए. दिस इज वॉट, दिस इज गिवन वेट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल इंटू 1000. Why this put, why we put this 1000? To convert gram to kilogram. And in the previous equation, to convert milliliter into liter. Then the unit will be mole per kg. Then there is two equations, molarity and molality. Molarity is WB upon MB into 1000 upon V. Then molality is WB upon MB into 1000 upon WA. This is what? This is number of mole of solute present in per liter of solution. This is molarity. And in case of molality, this is number of mole of solute present in per kg of solvent. So this is the very basic things. Then normality is number of mole of gram equivalent, number of mole of gram equivalent of solute present in per liter of solution. This is very important. Normality, number of mole of gram equivalents present in per liter of solution. Then we can write what is gram equivalent. So gram equivalent is given weight upon equivalent weight. Then a new term, equivalent weight. What is this? Then equivalent weight is molecular weight upon charge. Molecular weight upon charge. Sometime we know this charge as factor also. Now what is this charge? Like in case of NaCl, it gives Na plus plus Cl minus, one cation and one anion. Then the charge is 1. If we have CuCl2, then it will give Cu2 positive plus 2Cl negative, 2 cations and 2 anions, then the charge is 2. If we have AlCl3, then it will give Al3 positive plus 3Cl negative, trivalent cation and 3 monovalent anions, then the charge is 3. Total positive charge and total negative charge should always equal, and that is the value of charge. So for normality we can write WB upon MB into V into 1000 into charge. WB upon MB into V 1000 into charge. Then this given weight is WB, this equivalent weight is W equivalent. Now this W equivalent becomes molecular weight, that is MB upon charge. So from this equation 1 and this equation 2, we can write normality as WB upon MB into 1000 into charge upon volume. Then this is the equation for normality. Now, one more interesting thing is that this normality is, this is what? WB upon MB into 1000 upon V. This is the equation for molarity. This is the equation for molarity. So we can write normality is equals to molarity into charge. We can write normality is equals to molarity into charge. So let's discuss a question related to this molarity, molality and normality. Calculate the normality and molarity of a solution of H2SO4 having weight 980 gram dissolved in 750 ml water. Okay, this is the question. 980 gram H2SO4 dissolved in 750 ml of water, then calculate normality as well as molarity. Then WB for H2SO4 is 98, because B stands for solute and H2SO4 is our solute. Always remember that B is for solute and A is for solvent. WB is 98, then MB, molecular mass of H2SO4. This is 1 into 2 plus 16 plus 16 into 4. And this will equals to 98 gram. Then volume of solution is equals to 750 ml. Volume of solution is 750 ml. Then molarity will be equals to WB upon MB into volume into 1000, because this volume is in ml. Then the final answer will be WB is 980, MB is 98, volume is 750 and there is 1000 also. 1000 upon 75. What is this? This is mole per liter. This is mole per liter. This is the answer of molarity actually. Now, if we want to calculate normality, then it will be molarity into charge. Then what is the value of charge for H2SO4? This is equals to H2SO4 goes to give 2H positive plus SO4 2 negative. 2 value for positive charge and minus 2 value for negative charge. Then the charge will be 2. So normality is equals to molarity into 2. Then this is 1000 upon 75 into 2. This is equals to normality. And unit of normality is what? Unit of normality is gram equivalent per liter. Gram equivalent per liter. Okay guys, so in the next live session we will discuss some important numericals for the basic concepts related to concentration term. So keep watching G Chemistry as well as my channel, that is Dr. Akash Singh. We will provide you the best quality lectures for all types of exams related to senior secondary as well as the higher level competitive exams like NET, CSIR, JRF and so many types of useful competitive exams based on your favorite subject chemistry. And like, share and subscribe our channels. Okay guys, thank you for your support. Have a good day. Bye.